We do have the Knight of Swords, and we do have the Hermit, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius energy, Virgo energy, but I feel that at this time, Knight of Swords in reverse is not taking any action because we are deeply thinking, right? We know the Hermit is all about the soul's journey. It's all about the wisdom from past lessons. It's all about us and the light within, right? And King of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, and the Knight of Swords. Again, in action, you might be dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, or Capricorn, and at this time, we are not taking any action. It's more about the soul journey than doing something about. And we do have the Seven of Swords. Some dishonesty, but it doesn't have to be bad, right? It's the energy of, I keep it for myself. Can also be maybe this person of yours, they cheated, lied, and deceived you, and now we are like suspended, but thinking about, you know, because it has a meaning. Whatever dishonesty, whatever secret somebody's keeping, and whatever approach they take to life and partnership, it has like a deep seed in it. We do have the Empress and the Knight of Swords. We are not giving, we are not extending, we are not making any move. And it has this energy, Sagittarius, the Empress in reverse is the energy of I have nothing left to give, right? And the Six of Cups, except to the kids, probably, right? Some of you having kids with this person. Somebody here is generous, he's kind, and takes responsibility despite the inaction. The Emperor in reverse. We don't want to have the Emperor in reverse. It's all about manipulation and abuse of power. So can be an Aries, an innocent Aries, you know, for some of you. But I feel that with the Seven of Swords, the Emperor in reverse, the situation became hidden, dishonest, manipulative. It has a sense of lies, but most importantly, it has a sense of not taking their responsibilities, or maybe you were not able to take your own responsibilities to this. We do have the Star in reverse, Aquarius energy, the Three of Swords in reverse, and the Five of Pentacles. Absolutely rejection. We do have rejection over here. We do have pain, but we are overcoming. All this is in reverse. All this is in reverse, right? Let's see what turned. And the Page of Wands. This might be you feeling like a kid at this time because things are, you know, overwhelming and painful. We are on the right track though, Sagittarius, right? All the energies of the recovery are here. We are on the right track, but still, Page of Wands, right? We might be feeling a little bit that we need to start over. For some of it's about communication, right? Had a time where no communication happened to this person because of separation and pain, we have two energies here saying that communication will happen. Five of Pentacles in reverse is somebody opens lines of communication after rejection, and the Page of Wands is the energy of communication. So I would expect that, but then we are healing, so what type of meaningful communication can we have when we are in a process of, right? So some food for thought for some of you. Now let's look into the current energies and let's have the possible outcome between you and your person. Bottom of the deck, Ten of Pentacles, definitely the energy of a family, and the Two of Cups. I love this, the outcome is beautiful. The outcome and the Star, Two of Cups. For some of you, might be dealing with somebody in the public eye or something. It has an energy here of somebody being watched. You know, the Star is the person, you know, maybe working in the public eye, or somebody who is, I'm going to say notorious. I feel that this is about a family somewhere. You know, where there was love and there was healing, but then we went back to pain and rejection again, and we have like, you know, in and out, up and down kind of connection. So Sagittarius, in the past, we do have the Four of Pentacles in reverse and the Chariot, Cancer energy, and it's kind of like the universe saying, well, you had to go, you had to go, you had to drop it and let it go. Four of Pentacles is the energy of I had enough. I've been holding on to this for too long. I have a sense of it's unacceptable. I don't know who this pertains to, but it has an energy. It is unacceptable. It has an energy of I said so many times, and it has the energy of probably it happened like we woke up in the morning and we were gone by the end of the day, kind of energy, right? Because the Chariot, when it comes to love, it is the energy of breaking free. It is the energy of I need to breathe, I need to get out of here. And the combination by excellence is one of I'm done, done, done. Like not angry, not upset. I'm just done, And you had to do something about it. And it's on your side, right? Now, this person of yours, Four of Wands and Queen of Swords, Gemini, Libra, or Aquarius, but definitely committed, Sagittarius. If you've been married to this person, they really believed, and that was your question because it shows up here as a pretty clear answer here. And if you are wondering, right, they show up with the energy of roots and commitment of kids. Community being involved, around you, around the home, and the Queen of Swords. They might have been, kind of cold or coming with an energy of wisdom and coldness, and maybe something was no longer fun. It is a strong energy here of, really being cold and calculated and doing what's right and always like somebody being annoying with making no mistakes and something. So I kind of feel this is what happened, and then there was an explosion and probably kids were involved. We do have kids here, Six of Cups and the Tower, right? Whoever decided to walk away was an explosion of a home set, right, of some sort. And a lot of missing, of course, and a lot of longing, and a lot of, but it had to come down, right? The tower in the past. And such explosive energy is the Chariot with the Tower. Very unexpected kind of ending in this connection. And of course, financial problems over here between you and your person. Being lost. It has the energy of depression, the Star in reverse. It has the energy of feeling lost and feeling depressed and not feeling guided and not knowing which way to go, right? The Star in reverse. So it had an impact. So what are we right now, Sagittarius, in a beautiful spot? We do have the Page of Pentacles. We have it twice. Do we have it? No. No, we have the Page of Wands. Page of Pentacles and the King of Cups, and I do feel this is your energy, and it's a combination of I'm going to build my stability again because emotionally I'm good. I'm at peace with my decision, right? And it has a strong energy of being at peace with your decision. And King of Cups, of course, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, for some of you can be a water sign. We might be living, for some of you, leave behind an air sign and we move towards the water sign. But if I have to think about the most powerful energy, I feel it's just you being at peace with a decision, being at peace with starting over. Page of Pentacles is really learning a new skill, having a new endeavor, a new affair, a new project, a new you name it, because we are just good, a sense of emotional peace that we are right now in. Now, this person of yours, King of Pentacles in reverse and the Judgment, they feel unstable at this time. They might be a financial instability there and expecting a judgment, a sentence, a decision to bring them back the financial abundance that they've known in the past. For some of you, this is a decision they are making, right? At this time, if it's, of course, the judgment doesn't have to be legalities and like divorce and stuff, but can be, them being in a place of final decisions in order to get financially back on track and feel more stable. Somebody here needs to make decisions about a home. An environment to live in. About the family, we have Ten of Pentacles and the King of Pentacles, right? And it also has the energy of being drained, right? Upright, we know it's a lot of nurturing and loving energies. It's part of the Empress energy. But at this time, right, we are not really there. Mutual energies between the two of you, Four of Cups in reverse and the Ace of Swords in reverse. And this is the energy where we missed an opportunity to have a meaningful conversation. It has the energy of beating about the bush, right? Where you want to talk, they want to talk, but then we don't. For so many reasons, right? You want to keep your peace of mind. They are in a weak spot, I have to say. You know, they are not in a place. They are in a place where they need to make fundamental decisions. They are in a place of rebirth and awakening, of course, but it's like the financial part of it kind of draining them down and being on their mind. And I say that because it showed up with a lot of stability and roots. It's kind of like the universe saying you were their stability and roots. And now it's like everything is uprooted and they are going through a rebirth of some sort, right? A need to close the past and open to the future. And a lot of unspoken words and a lot of missed communication. Missed, not miscommunication, but missed opportunities to share what you need, what you want, what crosses your mind, the decision you've made to simply leave everything in the past or they've made, right? So the outcome of this all, oh my God, Sagittarius, are you kidding me? Nine of Pentacles and Temperance and both, I mean, this is your energy. This is you being abundant. And, you know, it has the energy of financial stability, independence, focusing on your health and well-being and wealth and you name it, right? And just being good and just being at peace. In peace with the decision, in peace with your emotions, in peace with yourself, and in peace within the balance that this new situation brought your way. Now, this person of yours, of course, they struggle. We do have them with the Hangman in reverse. This is kind of the universe saying, if you ask them what is their responsibility to it, they would say, this is none, you know, I've done nothing kind of energy. And then the Five of Cups in reverse, right? Regrets, guilt, overwhelming emotions, but again, not looking at, right? What is my responsibility? Guilt and remorse is the Five of Cups. It is in reverse, and because of the combination of energies, like, no, I've done nothing, I don't deserve this, I actually deserve stability, I gave everything, I was committed. That's their whole energy, Sagittarius. I've been committed, I've been a good husband, a good wife, you know, I was the one keeping it together with the King of Pentacles, and now I'm the one paying the price or unstable. It has an energy here. And it's kind of like not looking at this situation from a place of trying to understand and getting enlightened. It's more like, who's guilty, right? Mutual energies between the two of you, the King of Wands and the Fool in reverse. And this is you, Sagittarius, and let's make sure we don't rush a decision of some sort. They don't rush. It is the energy of resisting new beginnings. So, again, coming from two different places. On your side, you are good with the new beginnings. This person of yours, they are resisting a new beginning away from you. They might have a foolish behavior, impulsive and childish at this time, and reacting in some way. But we're good, Sagittarius. We are absolutely good. I don't know who's in love here, Sagittarius. Maybe somebody is in love. Maybe you contemplate a new beginning. Maybe you left to have like a new beginning with somebody, but there is absolutely healing love coming your way. For some of you, it's something that you have no idea, but it's, right? It has the energy of passion, love, healing love and stability and feminine. I feel that somebody is absolutely ready after a long period of a hurt, you know. For some of you, it is love coming, absolutely. But at this time, just without the overall, it's, I'm good. No matter what, I'm just good. So let's ask for some guidance over here. Let's see what we need to do. So we do have finances and career Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. So for some of you divorcing, right? Well, this person clearly doesn't have the same resources and they might feel unstable at this time. You are kind of called to look into. We do have express your love. I know somebody has a new love here. Express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. That is a Sagittarius here in separation and having a new love. Separation. Time apart from your partner is on the horizon. We have somebody in separation and we have also a new love. And somehow money and somehow career. And we have unrequited love, bottom of the deck. That is not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. And children might be there. When we have children in the past, the tower with the children. I know, Sagittarius, right? We have a connection where there is no longer love, there is separation, kids involved, and then we have express your love, that is the love that you have for someone. Let's see with whispers of love and true love decks. Let's see what we have. We have dating. I know, right? Dating, starting a new connection, starting a new relationship with somebody, expressing love while dealing with separation, kids, and unrequited love. We do have sexuality, dating and sexuality. Somebody here actually, right? Either you need to focus on, either we are dating to have a little bit of fun, you know, can be like a mature understanding between you and this new person you're dating, that, you know, we are having, you know, kind of friends with benefits type of connection. We do have boundaries though, you know, sexuality and boundaries and dating. So somebody here kind of needs to look into whatever that means for you, Sagittarius. Dating, sexuality, and boundaries. And we do have spent quality time together, listen and talk to each other. And it's interesting, maybe you just opened up to somebody and they are using you, Sagittarius, and that's kind of the heads up. Because we have dating, sexuality, boundaries, and spend quality time, right? It has to be more than sex. It has to be quality time. It has to be listening and understanding and having meaningful conversations. And Sagittarius, love is all around you. That is love everywhere all the time. Simply acknowledge this as truth. Absolutely. I mean, the universe cannot be more clear. You must be kidding me, right? Definitely a separation, definitely a new love. In this new love, we need to pay attention, right? And set some boundaries when it comes to sexuality. Sagittarius, let's see the energies we need to put back into the flow. And we have imagination. I embrace and nourish the creative aspect of my mind. And when it comes to dating, finances, and career, you need to use your imagination. Maybe you just met somebody at work. You know, dating somebody in the workplace is always tricky and you kind of need to use your judgment and your imagination. We do have surrender to setting limits, and such times you have twice limits and boundaries, right? So it is healthy to set boundaries in relationships. Practice expressing your needs and remember that no is a complete sentence. We do have surrender to the beauty of the natural world, so we do need to spend time in nature. It's so grounding and it helps. So take a relaxing break and spend time in nature. Replenish yourself by feeling the beauty and the ecstasy there. For some of you, it comes with a separation energy, so maybe this is when we pack our bags and we, you know, we move away in some place where we can ground ourselves and spend time with ourselves. We do have one card flipping, and it is surrender to your intuition. Tune in to your inner voice. Be aware of any gut feelings, flashes, knowings, or aha moments that come through to guide you. And bottom of the deck, we have surrender worry. So Sagittarius, make a commitment not to lead an anxiety-driven life. When worries arise, breathe them out of your body. Focus on the power of your heart and have faith that spirit is guiding you always. Beautiful. And let's have some general guidance. And I don't remember what decks I combined, angel guidance or something. and life purpose. So let's have just three of general guidance, something we need to know. And we do have infinite abundance, and it is the your outcome energy of the Nine of Pentacles, infinite abundance. So Sagittarius, you're fully supported as you devote yourself to your divine life purpose. So you are guided, and honestly, the energy coming your way is very career driven and focused on abundance and making money. So you do have infinite abundance. You have twice kind of a confirmation. We do have school. The answer that you're seeking involves going to school. So maybe somebody is teaching, or somebody needs to go back to school to find out something. And guess what? You have twice beauty of the world and fresh air. Somebody needs a distance, a little bit of distance between you and your situation. So Sagittarius, your body needs refreshment from oxygenated air generated by grass, trees, plants, and flowers. Spend time outside today as near to Mother Nature's cradle as possible. Open your curtains and windows to refresh your home as well. So yeah, twice. Somebody needs to get out there, Sagittarius. That is a message for somebody. Focus on your career and your abundance at this time. You're good. If you start something new, make sure nobody is using you for sex and taking advantage, right? And guess what? Infinite abundance. You have the answer for this. So Sagittarius, you know I love you. I wish you nothing but the best. I want you to stay strong and safe. And come see me next time. Love you. Take care.